Welcome, Lumineers. I'm your host, Rush, and today we're taking a look at the Metawatch. We have a 1K from Cerberus Den. It's a smaller event, but it still has some good information for us. And we'll also take a look at the Pixelborn data that's been provided by Gillibyte. You can take a look at him. He has a YouTube channel as well. This is going to be the Season 2, Week 3 update. The information on screen is from Gillibyte and provided by Pixelborn. He does a great job of updating it every week. So if you're part of the Pixelborn Discord channel, you can find it under weekly statistics. This is going to take a look at the top 10 games played, as well as the win ratio for those decks. So this is through December 1st to December 8th. In the top 100 players data only, we have 5,200 games played, or 5,824 if you want to be specific. We have a breakdown here showing Bounce Control out of Amethyst Ruby being the most games played at just over 2,100. Amethyst Ruby Hyper Control, or what we would consider more of our traditional control from the first chapter with a few updates, at 980 games played. Steel Song coming in with 966 games played. The new Flute variant has 912 games played. Emerald Steel Discard coming in with 721. And the rest you can see on the screen in front of you. The interesting one to note is the Mufasa Roulette, which has become popular by another YouTuber, which is pretty interesting to see here. So if you look at the just under 6,000 games played, it's looking like almost half are these top 10 decks. So that's a pretty good snapshot of what we should be seeing in higher competitive play. Now, taking a look at the chart to the left, it shows our Bounce Control is coming in with a win rate of 52.92%. So just over 50%, which is showing pretty strong. Just below that, we have 51.65% with Hyper Control. Steel Song is coming in at 48.49%. So a little underutilized, but it has good matchups into a lot of decks. The Steel Song Flute variant is coming in at 49.75%. So not too bad overall. The win rate for Emerald Steel Discard is coming in at 51.50, which is a little surprising to see, but it does have some powerful card combinations in it, so I'd like to put a Deku Tech together for that just to see what exactly is pushing it over the top. I'm going to skip a few of these here, and we're going to go straight over to Hyper Aggro Amber Amethyst, which is coming in at just over a 50% win rate at 50.85, and we'll skip a few more. And we'll go over to Popsicle. The Ruby Sapphire Popsicle Control deck is still sitting at 53.06. So as far as what we've normally been considered the top decks in the meta, that's still coming in with a surprisingly high win rate compared to what we've been seeing. But I know it has some fairly poor matchups in the meta right now. And then the biggest surprise amongst all these is that Mufasa Roulette deck that we're seeing somehow has a 56.29% win rate. And we're talking about just under 600 games played, so that's nothing to scoff at coming in at the surprising. So we'll definitely have to do a deck check for that to see if that's a credible amount or just no one knew what they were playing against. We'll give a couple of those decks a try. Let's get into the only paper tournament that I saw coming up for this last week. It was from Cerberus Den, has 28 players. Almost all of the color combinations were represented. We're only missing four. There's 11 out of 15 color combinations that were represented, so a pretty diverse field. But again, a smaller tournament with only 28 players. We have the whole top eight deck lists. Let's go ahead and take a look, see who pulled first place. First place does look like it went to Steel Songs. It looks like a pretty mid-range version of the deck. It is notably not running any Carefree Surfer Stitches. It's definitely not running Flutes, so I would definitely consider this a mid-range variant and pretty standard as far as that. Interesting to note that it does only have one copy of Rapunzel. Looks like they subbed in the rest of the Rapunzels for the 5-drop Beast, which is a pretty powerful card amongst itself. And only 2 copies of the Tinkerbell and no low-drop Tinkerbells. In second place, we did have the Mufasa Roulette, which is Amber Ruby. So this is a good deck list for you, for anybody who wants to playtest that out. This is definitely the one I will be using, probably for the deck tech that we will be putting together later this week. We have a couple copies of Stitch, so we can get into Rockstar Stitch later in the game. Same thing with the Queen. We have the later shift option. It's running the both Mother Gothel, or sorry, it's running the 2-drop Mother Gothel, so it can take advantage of the Rapunzels, which is one of the most powerful combinations in this deck. We are running the 2-drop Queen for an early rush, which does help prevent aggro decks from getting out of control. Dock is always a good option. When it quests, it makes things cheaper, which is perfect. We have the evasive Minnie Mouse. Of course, we do have Mufasa. Maui, Lady Tremaine, all staples. This is running Carefree Surfer and Maleficent. And being the fact that it is Amethyst Ruby, I am not surprised to see copies of Lantern in here. Next up, we have another Amber Steel deck. This is the Song's Flute variant. It does look like a copied deck list from the winner last week. Ah, that is incorrect. I am noticing right now it is a little bit of a hybrid Steel Songs mid-range deck. It is running copies of Benja and the 5-drop Beast, and it is running Tinkerbells. So it's limited a lot of the lower drops. And we have a lot of 3 and 2 of copies in here. So a little bit more diversity. It's still running the World's Greatest Criminal Mind. This might be where I think the meta settles out. The standard flute variant is a little more aggro-y. This will definitely hold up better probably against the mid-range decks. Then in third, so that was 3rd/4th. This is also 3rd/4th, so they probably didn't split it, or they tied. This is a Amethyst Emerald deck. Looks pretty straightforward aggro with a little bit of bounce tech thrown in there. It's not running Bibbidi Bobbidi Boo, so I wouldn't call it a full bounce deck. It is utilizing Archimedes Pascal for the low drops. Surprised to not see Maleficent in there. But it looks like they're trying to get more value out of people challenging into them. They are running the Enchantress Flynn Rider for their 2 drops. For 3 drops, they have Madam Mim, Fox, Arthur, which is not surprising. It's pretty much a staple in that deck. And then it looks like they just curve out into the standard layout of the deck. Nothing really surprising to see here. And for 5th through 8th place, we have another Steel Songs variant. Looks again very mid-range. Another Steel Song variant. This is a little bit more of the mid-range, not the standard flute deck, because again, it is running Beast and Benja. So this looks like a copy of the one we just saw a moment ago. We do have the first Amethyst Amber deck on the list. So our Hyper Aggro. Taking a look at the list here, it looks pretty standard for the Flood Out option. So it's not playing on the curve. It has a lot of low drops trying to utilize Rockstar Stitch. This is not my favorite variant for this version of the deck, but it can run pretty strong. I just find it doesn't have as much consistency if you don't find those Rockstar Stitches. I do like the 4 copies of Befuddle in the deck. This would be a pretty strong deck, and it looks like it would also be a fairly affordable option of the deck right now. And the last deck that we have on the list is one I have desperately been trying to put a game together for, but we keep having different decks pop up in the meta. This is Amethyst Steel. So it's running a lot of challenger options like Captain Hook. It does have the 2-drop Cinderella in here for the shift option later in the game with 7-drop Cinderella. Running 2 copies of Jafar. We do not have the shift option in here for Jafar though, which is interesting to see. 2 copies of Prince Eric. We have 3 copies of Prince Eric. So pretty standard early drop from what we've seen out of this deck style. Four copies of Maleficent for the card draw. Additional card draw on the deck is going to be Friends on the Other Side, which we have a standard four copies of. Interesting, we don't see Merlin Rabbit. We do have a little bit of item tech with Benja in the deck. Three copies of Merlin. Four copies of five drop Beast for some additional card draw. It is running four copies of Yzma as well, which is definitely something we've seen in the deck. Three copies of Tinkerbell, Giant Fairy. Three copies of early game or Ursula for the late game, as well as three copies of Elsa. Does look like there are a fair amount of uninkables in the deck. Actually, I take that back. It looks like they're running 10, 13. That's not too bad. That would probably explain why they don't have the whole new worlds in here. Three copies of Smash. This is a lot of single target damage. I don't know if you need the Smash in this deck. I'd rather put the additional copies of Strength of a Raging Fire in here so you have more, a fair amount of consistency, and you have the singing option because you have a fairly decent curve for three drops. And only three copies of Grab Your Swords. Well, as far as the decks that I was expecting to see this week, I would have expected to see a little bit more Amethyst Ruby, but otherwise this kind of comes in line with what we're expecting to see in the meta right now. A lot of Ambersteel Song. I would definitely see as many Amethyst Ruby as Ambersteel Song in most tournaments right now. We'll probably see a pop-up in the meta of Amber Ruby. And we will probably throughout the entire edition see Amethyst Amber aggro. So just keep up to date. If you have any comments, please put them down below. And as always, guys, thank you for watching Illumineers. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring that bell to stay up to date on everything Lorcana. I'll see you on the next one.